Oh, that's better. Hello, everyone, and welcome back to the walkthrough. So, it's time to go ahead and wander about other places, I suppose. Well, not I suppose, I mean, we're definitely gonna do that. But by wander, I mean, we're gonna go back to the Sand Kingdom, because I do believe I can now start the whole tourist taxi dealio that I talked about before, so let's go. Namely because the guy goes to the Metro Kingdom at some point, so it's like, well, yeah, I'm going there this part anyway, so might as well get to it then. And we're off. Woohoo! Oh, I didn't mean that. Well, trying to be all fancy, but no, I couldn't be that fancy. A taxi, you pulled up, finally! Take me to the Metro Kingdom! Sorry about the holdup. Had some car trouble you would not believe. Well, I think the people that were frozen in the ice could believe it. Can't leave for the Metro Kingdom yet, though. I promise I'll get you there. Just gotta decide the everything. What? What do you have to decide here? What? Are you just gonna go there? I think you're just gonna go there, if I recall correctly. I think. But yeah, there so, Metro Kingdom it is. He's going to appear, I think, over at the very, very beginning of it, right when the road starts in front of the bottomless pit, if I recall correctly. So, let's go ahead. I also gotta adjust the camera, it's sliding all over the place. There we go. It was like sliding and turning. You're probably going to hear more stuff from the left speaker because it was rotating towards the weight of the screen. Yeah. Anyway. Let's go! Moonrock here is glowing too. Let's be sure to check that. Yes, but not quite yet. I mean, I guess I could. I was gonna say not quite yet because I was focused on the other stuff, but hey, you know what? Fine. I'll do it now. It's just right here in my face, and then I can just warp around freely and stuff. And what was once a block has transformed into moons, many moons, and I do mean many here. Check it out. Look at all those twos on there. Okie dokie. Now, taxi guy should be right here. Yep, that's what I thought. Woohoo! So you can't. Yeah, you always gotta talk to Tostarina guy first. Well, Desert Wanderer, I should say. Hiya, you again. Went in the Sand Kingdom, remember? Or don't ya? It was only less than a minute ago, but anyway, need to bump into you. Best part of travel? The people you meet. Here's a gift, friend! And a tourist in the Metro Kingdom! Heck yeah! I've seen the sights. Take me to a new place. Like to see a waterfall. Big one! Biggest ever! No problem. I'll get you there in a jiff. Just gotta get the mayor's autograph and we're out of here. How the heck is he even driving the people to all these different locations? I mean, these are like, all these places are surrounded by bottomless pit of death. Perhaps we shouldn't question the game logic. Or maybe. The taxi cab can fly. It's got some propellers that pop out of the top or the sides or something like that. Maybe? That's my best explanation. So no universal implosion. Despite the downest death that is around every one of these locations. But anyway, so here we are. The cab? Where is the cab over here? I can't see it in the preview. Oh, there it is! Just popped in out of nowhere. Alright. Hello. It's me, your friend from, well, the Sand Kingdom, but also the Metro Kingdom. I'm the taxi guy. I mean, he's the taxi guy, but I'm the guy riding the taxi. Here, gift for you! Yeah! A tourist in the Cascade Kingdom! Yeah! I'm up for a bite, some neat eats, yummy grub, major meals, no place like the- Oh no! I forgot to go over to the Food King- Well, I guess I could head over there. I know the perfect place, we'll be there in a flash. Once I get a chance to pet one of those giant metal pooches they got here. I would not pet those if I were you. But that's entirely up to you. But yeah, I forgot that they head over to Luncheon Kingdom. Well, looks like things are going to be slightly disorganized out of my initial plan. Because I thought they just went over to the Metro and then back over to the Cascade. And yeah, but it's sounding like gotta pop in for just one moon to Luncheon Kingdom. And needless to say, what you might have seen there was that I 100%ed the Cascade Kingdom there, because that was the last moon. Alright, where's the cab this time? Because obviously it doesn't show in the preview. Yeah, I know. Moon Rock here is glowing too, let's be sure to check that. I'm gonna have to add this clip in later on when I come back to this place. Just like I do when I do seeds and stuff like that. I think there's something going on in the plaza. Well, anyway, I don't know what that. I mean, I guess I could flop on over there. Maybe cab guy is all the way over there getting the food, because that's where the main. Holy poopers! Yeah, he is over here. No way! We already met in the Sand Kingdom, Metro Kingdom, and Cascade Kingdom. You hop all over the place, don't ya? Hey, here, a gift. Wow! First in the Luncheon Kingdom, and we are officially disorganized again. Look at top this place. I mean, tip-top sky high and maybe above and beyond? Whoa, you sure you're up for this? Because I know a place. We'll head out as soon as I grab some stew. Above and beyond, can't wait. I do believe that means the Cloud Kingdom. So, we're going over there. Wait, no. But actually, I'm not above and beyond. I think it means the moon, actually. Oh, shoot. Because, yeah, I ran out of stuff at the Cloud Kingdom. Yeah! Remember, I got everything checked off the list over there, so I think it is referring to the moon. So let's go over to the moon just as soon as this loading sequence ends here. And Skipperoonie. Oh man, disorganized on top, disorganized. There they are! No spacesuit required. Out of this world! You got up here? How did you get up here? You've come a long, long way since the Sand Kingdom. Don't you just love the stars? Here, take this, a gift for you. Yeah! A tourist in the Moon Kingdom. Hard to beat this place, but how about, kingdom with the rarest mushrooms anywhere. You call that a challenge, friend? Do I have the place for you? Just gotta give the car a lot of gas first. So, where could we find the place that has mushrooms? A kingdom that has mushrooms. Wait a second. Could it be the Mushroom Kingdom? Why, I would bet so. Oh yeah, it's all the way on the other. I don't know why they put that so, like, all the way on the back end of that. I never understood that. I always thought that the Mushroom Kingdom should have been, like, listed after the Moon Kingdom. Or maybe even, I don't know, even if they didn't want to put it after the Moon Kingdom because it was disorganized, the Moon and then Dark Side and then Darker Side in terms of their order, they could have maybe, like, put it behind the Moon Kingdom because it's closer? Or something? That's, well, yeah, maybe I'm overthinking this again. I shouldn't be surprised, but I am. It's you! Remember when we met in the Sand Kingdom? Yes, in the Metro. And the Luncheon, and the moon, and the Cascade. Love this place. Dental, peaceful. Ah, makes me want to settle down. Or at least give you this. Wah! The tourist in the Mushroom Kingdom. This is going on a lot longer than I thought it would. Driver, good job. Got one more place to go to. Back home. Take me to the Sand Kingdom? Glad to, friend. I'll get you home just as soon as I can. I'm just gonna load up on antifreeze first. So, alright. Sand Kingdom. It is. Let's plop this one moon here that I couldn't get earlier into the Odyssey. It's just ticking it up one at a time now. And let's go. Back home. Here. Yes. Even though you come to the Sand Kingdom long before. The mushrooms. No. It's listed after the Mushroom Kingdom. And I wonder if they're right by where they were before. We'll find out. Yes, they are. Why do I keep throwing my hat when I just... All it is ZL. And the Y button. Hey, welcome back. Who knew I'd meet you here? See you all over and meet you here again? Crazy. I love home. Nowhere nicer. Nowhere friendlier. But great to bump into you everywhere. So here, a gift. And the Sand Kingdom is 100% it as well. Round the world tourists. Glad to be your driver. It's been quite a ride. Or flyer, or rocket pilot to the moon. I'll never forget. Trip of a lifetime. What a trip. Truly fantastic. So let's just take a look-see at our lists. 89 out of 89. I've got to go back the other way. Cascade Kingdom 40 out of 40. Beautiful. Beautiful. And, whoop, I went back too far. Alright, now we can go ahead and continue the Metro Kingdom, I guess you could call it. I don't want to say I start the Metro Kingdom's post-game, because I technically already did that when I went there to get a moon on this whole travel quest. And, you know, come to think of it, maybe it's good that I did this round-the-world trip now, even though it's slightly disorganized in a way, because it is still all together. And the fact that I got these travel around moons done means that I'll have an idea of which kingdoms won't have those in the future if there's like some sort of moon that I can't get at a moment in time, and maybe it'll remind me of what the poop it is in the scoop. Alright. Metro Kingdom, we begin. And actually, just out of curiosity, can I, like, maybe I can? I probably could actually make that without using the power line. Like, if I did some more proper physics abuse long jumping or something like that. Like, remember I mentioned before in the Lost Kingdom that if you go and angle yourself towards the land, that you can actually get a much longer long jump out of that. That was not the physics that I was looking for. Maybe I shouldn't mess around with that and just go ahead and collect some moons, because what I can really do is just warp on over here. Just I don't have to use the power line or any fancy jumps or anything like that. Alright, watch us. I did it! Anyway, over here... Well, there's a timer challenge now, but I'll get that on the way back here. I feel a spirit of remote control in you. Step right in. Remember this place? There's a new challenge. Trick is not to bump into stuff. Super exciting! Pretty sure getting under 20 seconds is totally impossible. How my kids are so good at this! We're about to find out. Alright. Prepare yourself. Just hold up. Remember, just adjust yourself with the right analog stick. Hold up the entire time. You just want to get a feel for those corners for maximum speed, after all. But yes, we gotta get an even tinier time than we did before, which means a little bit more efficiency, because I was pretty close to it before, actually, but there wasn't any prize, even if I would have reached it before at that time anyway, so I was like, would you look at that? Despite that iffy first lap, I can call that a voila moment of victory. RC car champ. And what does the people have to say about that now? Same thing. What about you? And if I don't come in earlier, okay. So, maybe someone else got 26 seconds, and once he seen someone else beat it, he was like, I'm never gonna speak of that again. Alright, hold it, and there we go. Don't throw the hat. In fact, there's no hat to throw this time. So maybe for all I know, I automatically tried to throw my hat, and actually didn't, because I didn't have a hat to speak of. And it's timer challenge 3. I guess it's a little faster to just warp to the rooftop garden and jump down from above. Probably, maybe. By the way, I'm also looking for someone sitting on a bench, by the way, because it... Oh yeah, I forgot you could throw your hat on there and unleash the spray of water. Oh, it's another timer challenge. Of course! Oh, that's not very hard at all. There's just teeter-totter platforms. Because as long as I'm doing triple jumps and side... Oh, that's right, I don't have my hat! Maybe it's harder than I thought. Of course. I was gonna say, that would be an easy hat jump on the way back, but... Nah. I gotta go probably further to the end here. And then... There we go. Voila! Metro Kingdom Timer Challenge 1! And there's purple coins up there. Look at that. How did I miss those bad boys? Well, quite frankly, I know I missed a bunch of things in this kingdom because there's so much stuff. Oh yeah, I was gonna give you a close-up view of these coins, if possible. Well, I can't go in the first person on this one, but you can see Pauline is on one side, and then the city is on the other side. Yep. There you go, that's a pretty good view right there, right between the bars. Alright, so we got those two. Still gotta get a whole bunch more coinages, but we'll get those as we go. Look at that, Moonpipe. Two of them down here. Oh boy. Prepare to cycle your way to victory. Well, it's more like scooter your way to victory. Ready? Because you gotta hit that switch, and I do mean... You gotta be ready for this. You gotta go, and I mean go. Because there isn't a lot of time. You can go up there and get some coins if you want to. This first part is just kind of like just a little warm up here. The second part is where things get serious. I wanna kind of get you out of my way here. Thank you. I can't jump stuff with the powers of the scooter. I mean, with the powers of the tank, excuse me. Okay, go. And by the way, remember this layout for later because of a certain highly difficult... Oh, shoot! Highly difficult something later on. Well, that was a failed run. I wonder if I should just skip the tank setup and then just go for it. Because I already know that there's stairs and stuff like that there, and I just go straight out from there anyway. And don't mind the cannonballs, just jump over them if you need to. And go! Okay, I'm mainly taking this route, I don't know, for the extra coins. And be sure to take this crate route. Oh no! Take the crate route over to the right. Because there's a secret moon over there, well, a secondary moon over there. The main moon is at the end of this course, so you're gonna have to, whether you take the crate route or not, you're gonna end up at that end place anyway, so might as well just go ahead and take the breakable crate route anyway. Alright, go. I know it's a little tricky to control as opposed to regular walking, but still, it's most certainly doable. Alright, I'm gonna take my turn a little wider this time. Okay, I guess they aren't like crates, they're more like... Ooh, shoot! It's breakable scaffolding. Ooh! Oh. Alright. Victory is mine! And as you've seen, there wasn't really much over at the other routes. Motor scooter, daredevil. Victory indeed for that. I think that was... I made that a little harder than it actually needed to, because I think I had more speed to do that in a more casual way. But just for the fun of it... I know. I'm gonna do this one more time, but this time I'm gonna take all the routes that I didn't take before. Interestingly, you can just jump right over this, by the way, so you don't have to take the coin route, which you... It's kind of tricky to time, because it's like very, very close to the peak of your jump. That's why I always went for the coins. And the other one that I took is this boring side over here, which is slightly shorter. And the other one I didn't take was over down this way. Also kind of on the boring side in comparison to the other way. But yeah, it's, as you can tell, it's significantly easier than taking the other routes. But you kind of have to for the sake of that Power Moon, at least on that last route, I should say. Alrighty. Done! And... Oh, yeah. That's right, I still have to go and... do... Wait, yeah, it was... Wait, what is that referring to? Actually... Not this, because I just got that. Yeah, what? What? Is it directly above? The power lines! Okay, so I think there's a power line up here. And then I just gotta go while I'm on the power line. And then call it a day. For that one, because it's gonna be pretty easy just as long as I time myself correctly. Meow! Just automatically sucks you into it, crossing lines. And done. Let's see here. Could go into... Because I said I was going to go buy the clothes way back, and I kind of didn't. but I'm also kind of looking for a guy that's sitting on a bench. Remember I mentioned that? Because the guy that's... That guy right there! He's got a moon for us. Boy, I tell ya. This city. We sit down by him, we'll have a conversation. You're not from around here, are you? You're the first person to ever just sit down next to me. It's a lonely city. Thanks for reaching out. Take this for your trouble. And he's just packing a moon, just because. Bench friends! Heck yeah! Thanks, pal. You're welcome. Oh! Wait, did you say hi to me or that guy? Wait, sit down with this guy! He needs other buddies too! Oh man... Mario being the silent protagonist, not helping things. Let's see here. Oh, the Koopa. I was thinking that maybe I should do this one here, because I think Pauline is looking for her purse at the moment now. I think. It's not the X. The X is something else over here, but I'm talking about this right here. How's it going? Hello. I've been waiting for you, Mario. We heard all about your heroics in the Moon Kingdom. Truly a hero's hero. You've come a long way since we've met. I wonder if you'd like to learn a bit about me. Maybe in quiz form? Maybe later. Okay. Okay, later is now. I just wanted to hear your dialogue. Sounds fun. Alright, here we go. Question? Which of these things did I actually do a long time ago? Well... you kind of would get the idea of this back when we did the 8-bit Donkey Kong Town when she was singing it. But what if we choose the wrong one? Oh. Raccoon suit? No, why would you so unaware of such a thing? Oh man, there's dialogue for each individual one? No way! Is there really? So that means I have to choose both? Oh! Oh man, if they... holy poopers. I might have delved down a rabbit hole I didn't want to delve down. I don't think she likes machines. That's okay. I just wanted to see your other dialogue. Not fake dialogue. No, machines that I have a mutual dislike. More sounds fun. Holy poopers. Oh, man. Oh man, yeah, she likes flowers, I do believe, but say you're driving RC cars. Machines and I have never gotten along, never even touched an RC. So that is slight, like, because we did learn about the machines thing there. But, so, yeah, I guess that translates to the RC car thing as well. Oh, man. Should I just skip this? Just answer things correctly? Actually, I don't know which one you'd want to visit right now. How about the Wooded Kingdom? That doesn't sound like a place that you'd want to go because of mosquitoes. Okay, good. As it happens, I'm bad with flowers and machines. Oh, so you don't like flowers either, okay. So the Wooded Kingdom is not my best option. Yeah, I don't know how I'm gonna tackle that. Yeah. What's that? Nothing we need now. What do you mean? Save that for later. But yeah, okay, since I'm not sure how I'm gonna tackle that, maybe I'll just end off the perk here, because I'm not getting your purse like I thought I was. So, yeah, with that, I'm gonna end off the perk here. I hope you enjoyed, and I'll see you in the next perk, and I think of what I should do about all that dialogue there. Can you imagine if there's a little bit of dialogue with each of the wrong quiz answers? Ugh!